Eberhard, you are an artist and a musician. So how did it all begin for you?
Yes, I studied fine arts in Düsseldorf at the Kunstakademie in Düsseldorf. And besides painting, I made experiments with different instruments. In my room where I studied art in Düsseldorf, I had different instruments like tenor saxophone, cello, guitar and all of this. And besides painting, I made some music for myself.
Why did you decide to go to Düsseldorf?
For me, Düsseldorf this time was the most important art academy of the whole world. Professor Josef Beuys was one of the teachers.
Josef Beuys, uh-huh.
Yes, yeah. Very famous professors. So I thought I could learn a lot there. So I went to Düsseldorf to study art in Düsseldorf. And you see, this is a painting I made last year. You see, it is a free kind of painting, abstract painting. I like freedom. For me, the free expression is very important in music and in painting too. So it is something like improvising. This painting is a very quick painting, something like improvising painting to show the feeling of the moment. And I'm doing the same thing with music. Maybe you can hear a little bit in the background. There's music I made last week. I play drums and some guitar. And this is a free working with sounds to put the energy.
So you don't, can I say it, you don't separate art and music? So it's maybe it's one thing for you, or?
Today it's one thing. I don't understand it myself. In former times it was separate. One thing was painting and art, and one thing was music. But since 10 years, everything goes together. I make a lot of performance art in museums, in galleries, and on the street. I am doing some paintings with music and all this, so it comes together. This is important for me. Yes, when I studied in Düsseldorf, I made music first for myself. And then I formed a group with some friends from the boys' class. We had the first band of free improvised music in Düsseldorf. The name of the band was Piss Off.
Piss Off?
The name was Piss Off.
Oh, yeah.
The music was like the name is Piss Off. So it was very hardcore music. We were five or six people. Everyone played what he liked to play. There was no special form. Everything was very free and it was very loud. The amplifiers were full size, so it was very loud, and very free. Electronic things with real instruments and all this. And Josef Beuys heard this one time and he said, we make a performance together in cream cheese. So in 68 we made this very famous performance with Josef Beuys together, the band Piss Off, and with Josef Beuys he made the famous Handaktion. With his hands he acted 3 hours and he made the sound 3 hours very loud and very noisy with the cream cheese. And after some of these cream cheese and Piss Off shows, I saw a young man in the public who came 2 months later. It was Florian Steiger Essling, who later made the band Kraftwerk. We became friends and made music together.
Can you speak louder, please?
Yes. And I can come nearer to you.
Okay.
And in 1967, I made the first Kraftwerk recording with Florian and me. I played double bass, cello, tenor saxophone and electro guitar, and Florian played the flute and violin.
Interesting.
The father of Florian made photos of us doing the music. And
so it was different than the other works of Kraftwerk later?
Yes. The first Kraftwerk music was very free, improvised music. And in 68, we got another musician in our band. It was Ralf Hütter. He played Hammond organ this time. And there was another musician who played drums. So we had a band with four people, drums, bass, Hammond organ and flute.
Oh, and who was the other person?
It was a drummer from Aachen. It was a friend of Ralf Hütter, and he was a good drummer, so we came together to make music in Düsseldorf and the towns around Düsseldorf. And so in 68, 69, we had this group with a quartet. Later on in 70, 71, Ralf Hütter quit the job of in Kraftwerk. He wanted to study architecture again in Aachen. And so the band Kraftwerk only consisted of Florian Schneider Essen in flute, Charlie Weiss drums, and I played cello, bass and Hawaiian guitar. And so we did some jobs in Düsseldorf and in towns around. And after this time of Kraftwerk, I played with Neu, the band Neu, with Klaus Dinger and Michael Rother. Before I played at the one time in the Kraftwerk time, I played together with Klaus Dinger and Michael Rother in Leverkusen in the Forum. So at the front there were two parts for Florian and me. We had the solo parts. And in the background there were two rhythm guitars. This was Michael Rother and Hushen Yadepur and Klaus Dinger on drums. But later we formed in 1972, we formed the group Neu with three people, Klaus Dinger, Michael Rother, and I played the bass, cello and Hawaiian guitar. And at the end of the year 1972, we had another bass player in the group from the band Guru Guru. His name was Uli Trepte.
So Guru died before some years.
Yes. Mm. So we made some tours here in Germany, played together, and I recorded 4 hours of this live music in concerts we had in Hamburg, Fabrik Hamburg, in the University of Münster and in the University of Freiburg, for example. And after Neu, I made my own group, Fritz Müller. It was an experimental German rock music with multimedia actions with film and theater on stage. And nowadays I'm experimenting a lot with performance art, with painting and music, free organized music, something like this.
Okay, thank you very much.